guys, this was another close call for our travel. We left Chicoteve this morning. Our train was supposed to leave at 7:25 in the morning. And then got there at like 7 because we were like, we cannot miss this train. He has his fitting for his runway show. We had to be in Milan at a certain time. So we got there early and everything, and we're sitting there, and it's like, your train is 10 minutes late, your train is 15 minutes late, your train is 20 minutes late, and we were supposed to connect with a different train. So we were like, no, we're gonna miss our connection and all this stuff. And finally, here comes the train out of the blue. So we get on, and we're like, okay, we're good, we made it. And then we get to the stop before we're supposed to switch trains, and this woman runs through the train, and she's like, Milano, 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 like, past. Oh, she just screams Milano and runs past us, and all these other people are getting off. We're like, wait, what's going on? Like, do we get off? Like, what's happening? We were just sitting there, and finally he was like, go ask her, go ask her. So I finally found her. I asked. It was like the train was almost leaving. She's like, yes, you have to get off here. So then we had to like grab all of our stuff and hurry off the train. We
didn't know what's going on. This would be no problem if we didn't have enormous bags that are super heavy. Yeah. We're idiots.
Yes.
Next time, super light. We ended up, everything we've been wearing almost is
we bought here.
It's just stupid.
Don't ever overpack for your other again.
It's not worth it. Like, even if you feel like you need a lot of clothes, just bring like underwear and socks, and then go to H&M or something, or like Zara, and get like cheap clothes. It's just not worth bringing it all everywhere.
You're so dumb. Anyway, we finally got on the right train, and it was all good. It was like super high stress situation.
Yeah, it's always just so crowded when you get on.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And they look at you like you're an idiot because you have so much luggage.
Which we are. Yeah, but anyway, now we're finally on our way to his fitting for the runway show tomorrow. So I'm going to try to film what I can. We were just talking, like, I wonder if they'll let me film. And we're just like, well, I guess we'll just film until they tell me not to.
Because it could be entertaining, especially if I don't fit into anything. Because I have this feeling that my arms and shoulders will be too big.
They're a lot bigger than just Europeans.
Yeah, it just always happens. I'm not like a huge guy, but compared to European guys.
Yeah.
So that was a huge relief. They took photos in between each look so that they coordinate it. There's a big team back there. It's pretty cool. Seamstress gets each outfit sized up, and then use the picture. You put it in a sleeve. It's all organized, and any accessories you have are labeled with your number, with your name. And I think it did a total of 3 looks, and they were all really nice. Nothing too crazy. There was one that was like super shiny, but it fit really good, and that's what's important. All the blazers fit me good. That's what I was concerned about, but it seems like the brand itself is for like more masculine, like older models, so it was just spot on for me. So
I got to watch a little bit through the window, and they looked really nice. I'm so excited.
What?
They're not hard-boiled.
What the heck? What? How are they not hard-boiled? What are we supposed to do with those? Think we're supposed to cook them over there?
Oh my god.
I suggested time frames. It's the day of the show. Gotta get one last bit of cardio in to help get rid of bloat and make me wake up. Feel half dead.
What is up, you guys? Okay, so it's the day of the fashion show. Weston has gone with the other models to the venue. I don't know what they're doing. They're just getting ready for the show and everything. So I'm here at the hotel still, along with a few other girlfriends from the models. And I believe they are going to organize a car for us to get taken to the venue here in about like an hour or so. But the show is in for another like 4 or 5 hours. However, I'm all dressed and ready because I don't know, like, I didn't want to bring in change of clothes, so I got ready for the actual show, and I'm going to carry my heels with me. I'm just thinking out loud. I'm going to carry my heels with me because I don't want to wear them for like 8 hours. So I'm just going to wear flats when I get there and then change into the heels for the show. But anyways, not like you care about that. You guys, this morning, Weston and I went to go do cardio after we ate breakfast, which you saw. During cardio, we got into this little funny argument about Instagram, and like we were recording it, and it was really funny and entertaining. And then my stupid self, clumsy self, I had the camera in my hand, I was on the elliptical, and you know how like the elliptical, like the arm grabby thing is connected to the feet, so when the feet go this way, the arm goes this way. I wasn't holding onto the arm, I was holding onto my camera like this. I moved my foot and the thing came and knocked the camera out of my hand. The camera went toppling over and falling on its lens and it broke. So we were just like, oh my God, the timing of this is horrible. Now I don't have a camera, so I can't record his show with my camera, and like, ugh, it was such a bummer. So I'm recording on my phone. We're still gonna get footage. Probably might not be as good of quality. I'm really sorry, I'm such a klutz. It's like seriously such a flaw of mine, and I'm really trying hard to be better, but so I'm filming with my phone now, so I'm sorry if it's shaky or not good quality, but I'm doing my best, so bear with me. I'm really excited for Weston's show. I think he's gonna do amazing, and I can't wait to see him on the runway. I'm gonna die. Okay, so I'll check in with you guys in a little bit, probably once I get there. Us that we're not allowed to go back to watch the show, that we can only be backstage, which is such a bummer because then I can't film anything. So I will get what I can, but check this out. This is all backstage.
Oh, you look so beautiful.
Okay, so since we can't watch the real show, we're gonna try to watch the rehearsal. So.
We have to be ready on time because Prada spends more money. In the lobby of the Beverly Hills Hotel. Okay, you just checked in. Some of you, it depends how you dress. Some of you are going to the pool, some of you are going. Just came with a private jet and arrived. You're walking in the lobby. There's all the beautiful girls waiting, looking at you. Just be cool, just be yourself. We are backstage again. He just put on his first outfit and I lost him. So I think I'm gonna go try to find a place to stand in the show. I doubt I will be able to, but I'll keep posting. At the moment we are in the lobby of the hotel, so you will enjoy. You will enjoy in this beautiful venue, the beautiful show of Billionaire. I just want to say three things. We started with Billionaire 2 years ago.
Today we have 25 stores. We're going to open a few more stores. What is very important for us is that the development of this brand is doing really, really more than we have ever expected. We're growing from year to year 50%. And we opened this year Paris, Monte Carlo, and also Amsterdam, which is very important for us because we believe in the retail. So I would like you now to enjoy the show. And I hope you have a nice day. And in case you're not happy, you can call the hotel director anytime.
Outfit you wore? Is this the jacket you wore?
Yeah. It almost looks camo right here.
It is camo.